Welcome to tonight's contest, where the Rochester Zebras will take on the Whitco Wildcats, brought to you in part by Shepherd Chevrolet Buick of Rochester. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick, where you always feel like family. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
Kennedy and Devin Adkins, the 6'3 sophomore for the Wildcats, will jump it off in center, and here we go. And the Wildcats control the tip. Cumberland for the Wildcats will bring it up across midcourt and work this right sideline against man-to-man zone or man-to-man defense by the Zebras. And there's the steal by Medina, and that's what got him in the starting lineup after a great holiday tournament last weekend.
Yeah, well, those heady, scrappy defensive plays Medina brings to the table is exactly why he's in the lineup. And unfortunately, right there is a play why he doesn't stay in there very long.
That's a problem that a lot of the Zebras have had. As we go through the holiday break, Medina picks up his first foul after the Alec Holland miss. And again, Cumberland will walk the ball to the floor for the Wildcats as he crosses the timeline. Over to Helbrig. Helbrig holds against Kennedy out top. And now Walpool to Adkins, back around the horn to Cumberland.
As Coach Reinhold said, this is something he's been wanting to continue to develop. He's been more of a man-to-man coach in his coaching career, and finally getting the guys kind of on board with what he's looking for in that particular defense. Obviously, yeah. Playing Medina and Kennedy at the same time gives a little more size. They're not out high like they have been sometimes.
And a couple of wild passes by the Wildcats, and now we're going to have a reach-in foul against Garrett.
Number 24, Alex first. Team second, couple quick fouls here in the first minute on the Zebras. Got to stay away from foul trouble.
Yeah.
Whitco struggling to score a little bit. You don't want to give them the opportunity to score from the free throw line.
Defensively, the Zebras doing a pretty good job of keeping them away from the basket as that shot by Walpool is long. And the long rebound comes down to Cumberland, but he's going to be called for stepping on the midcourt line. Brought the Whitco coach off the bench.
Yeah, I might tend to agree with the Whitco coach. I mean, just because his foot hit the line does not mean that's an over and back. You've got to have to establish
in the front court.
Yeah.
So Holland gets the ball in for the Zebras to Screeton. Screeton brings it across midcourt, working against the freshman Walpool. Gives to Holland in the corner. Holland driving baseline, throws up a shot, and he's going to be called for a player control foul charge.
Minute and a half and three team fouls. That's on one hand, as a coach, you know, you like the aggressiveness, try to go to the basket and create some offense. But, you know, the Whitco defender was firmly planted there. Easy call for the referee.
So Cumberland again walks the ball up for the Wildcats, gives to Walpool on the left side. Walpool working that left baseline against the man-to-man by Screeton. Over to Kern. Kern back to Cumberland. Cumberland sets the offense, works the right side against Garrick, driving the baseline, puts it off the glass, and it's good. So Cumberland giving the Wildcats the first points of the ballgame. Medina back to Garrick. Garrick working against Cumberland across midcourt, and we're going to get a touch foul against Cumberland.
Could be one of those nights. If you're going to call it this close, we may see a lot of free throws in the gym tonight.
Whitco foul number five, Dillon.
Holland will look to get it in off the sideline, does so to Garrick. Garrick across the top of the key. Working against Walpool, out to Screeton. Screeton to Kennedy. Kennedy's 15-footer is good. Kennedy ties the score at 2-2.
He's almost getting just about automatic on that shot, knocking down that 15-footer.
That's a good-looking shot, too. There's no hesitation there. So Cumberland will walk the ball up for the Wildcats. Gives to Helbig. Helbig working the right side back to Cumberland. Down to Adkins. Adkins working against Medina. Across court to Walpool, back to Kern. Kern, the top of the key, gives to Cumberland. And then to Helbig. The Rochester Zebras in a man-to-man. And Whitco being patient, working against that man-to-man.
He's very content to move the ball.
Yeah.
Not a lot of guys, looks like, that can create their own shots, so relying on passing, cutting, screening.
Rochester doing a good job of keeping them away from the inside. As Cumberland's three-pointer is off the mark, And the ball goes out of bounds and back to the Zebras. 5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. The score tied at 2-2.
Witko picking up the pressure here defensively. Looks like they're going to pick up the Zebras. A little bit of man-to-man pressure.
Try and create something. Holland looks to get it in. Does so to Screeton. Screeton will allow everybody to clear. And he'll walk it up against Walpole. Screeton to Kennedy. Outside the arc. Kennedy drives the free throw line. And we're going to have a bumping foul against Helblick.
All right. Second team foul on Witko.
So into the ball game now for Witko. Number 23 is Zalocki, a 6'2 senior, and number 3, Patrick, a 5'10 senior guard. Kennedy gets the ball into Holland. Holland looks at a three, drives just inside the free throw line. His shot's off the back of the iron. Rebound to Witko, and Cumberland will walk the ball up for the Wildcats. Gives to Walpole. Walpole drives to the free throw line. His shot no good. Kennedy with the rebound. Kennedy will bring it up across midcourt. Give off to Holland on the right side. Holland to Garrick. Garrick top of the key. Looks at the Wildcat defense. Gives to Screeton. Screeton looking down low. Drives the left side. Nothing there. It's back out to Garrick. Garrick puts a shot up. It's good. 4-12 left here in the first quarter, Rochester 4-2.
Nice to see the Zebras working on that mid-range game instead of relying just on the 19-footers to kind of get inside the paint, get inside that 10 to 15-foot range.
I agree. So Witko now working with the basketball. Walpole top of the key gives to Cumberland driving the baseline. His jumper in and out, no good. Garrick up high with the rebound for the Zebras. And he'll push it quickly up across midcourt. Back to Screeton. Screeton down low to Holland. Holland off the glass and good. Alec Holland kind of camping down low on the blocks. Gets an open passing lane from Screeton and
got lost in the trees.
Yeah,
it looked like Screeton to find him.
Walpole, top of the key for the Wildcats, gives to Cumberland. Cumberland driving to the free throw line, throws it off the face of a teammate, and they're lucky to get the ball back as Walpole now takes possession of the ball for the Wildcats, brings it back out front and sets the offense. Screeton working against him defensively. Cumberland over to Adkins. Adkins driving against Medina. Gives out to the top of the key to Adkins. His three-pointer is no good. Garrett quickly up the floor to Holland. Holland off the glass, no good. And he's going to be fouled by Adkins.
On the shot. Adkins first, Witko's third. Holland going to go line of shoot two.
So the Zebras doing a good job of clearing the board and getting the ball up quickly, trying to beat Witko to the other side of the floor.
Which has allowed some easy opportunities, or in that case, drawing a foul situation, get Holland the line.
Right.
Good free throw shooter.
Checking in for Witko.
And the sophomore hits the first one.
Checking in for Witko, number 33. Ian Kerr and number 15. Roger Elway.
Brandon Camp checks in for the Zebras.
Number 4, Brett Abbott. And
also Brett Abbott.
Holland's second free throw is up and good. 8-2, Rochester, 2:57 left here in the first quarter. I'm Brad Thomas, Tony Stasiak joining us tonight.
Zebras a little bit of the 2-2-1 half-court trap.
And looks like Witko's going to throw it away against that trap by the Rochester Zebras.
Nice making an extra effort play by Luke Kennedy to just get a hand on it, which deflected it just enough to where the Witko player couldn't control it cleanly.
Holland quickly up across midcourt, working against Walpole. Gives to Camp. Camp across to Abbott. Abbott back to Screeton. Screeton looking to drive in against the free throw line. Out to Kennedy. He puts up a three. It's good. Luke Kennedy's three-pointer is good, and the Zebras lead 11-2 with 2:23 left here in the first quarter. The Wildcats. Walpole brings it up, gives it to Patrick. He's trapped in the corner, and we're going to have a foul coming against Holland for Rochester.
Well, it's going to be an Alec Holland, unfortunately, his second here in the first quarter. Cardinal sin there in the trap is letting the ball handler step through the trap. Guys got to lock their legs a little bit closer together and not allow that dribble to go through.
Yeah, and Garrick will check back in, and Holland will sit down with two fouls.
Unfortunate, because I thought, Alex played a great game to this point. He's got 4 points, but he's really looking to attack the basket, not just settle for three-point jumpers.
You're right. And Witko now with the basketball. The jumper by Cumberland is good.
He's got all five Witko points.
And Garrett Kennedy quickly with another three. 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. It's 14-5 with a couple of quick threes by Cumberland Kennedy.
Luke's now got Cumberland eight.
Pushes it up quickly to Adkins. His jumper off the glass is no good. Blocked by Garrett. And the jumper by Cumberland, three-pointer is no good. Saved by Walpool. Kennedy chases down the loose ball. And now Kennedy will bring it up and give it to Screeton across midcourt. Screeton will bring it back towards the middle of the floor, give to Garrett. Garrett is going to give the camp to Kennedy for another three in the corner. It's good. Luke Kennedy with his third three-pointer.
It is. It is. He's already in double figures. He's got 9 points.
17-5 in favor of the Rochester Zebras with a minute 17 to go here in the first, and we're going to have a foul coming against Brett Abbott.
Foul's going to be on Abbott, his first. Double figures. Kennedy has 9 points on threes. He's also got a two. He's got 11 already
wow.
in this quarter. And
we said he was gonna, could have a big game tonight, and he's on his way.
We didn't think it was from the three-point line.
You're right. So Walpool gives to Cumberland, who gives back to Walpool at the top of the key, working against Screeton. Screeton playing pretty tight defense. Cumberland now on this right side will set the offense for the Wildcats. Over to Patrick. Patrick to Walpool. To Cumberland. Cumberland working against Garrick. 51 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Cumberland drives the baseline. Gives out to Walpool for a three. No good. Camp with the rebound. 43 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Camp quickly driving down. Has his pass stolen. But Camp, or Garrick, steals the outlet. And back for the Zebras. The Screeton resets with 31 seconds. Screeton will hold against the man-to-man by Witko. Gives to Abbott. 21 seconds to go here in the first. Zebras leading 17-5 on three three-pointers by Luke Kennedy. As Screeton sets the offense at the top of the key. Gives to Kennedy on this left side. Kennedy to Garrett. Garrett gets top of the key, drives down the baseline. His shot is partially blocked, and there's going to be a foul. So Garrett will be going to the free throw line with 1.7 seconds left. That foul comes.
Number 15, Roger
Helbig. Helbig is second. Whitco's fourth.
Hey, Garrett. At the line for the Zebras. First free throw is no good. They'll have one more. As
Witko, number 23, Danny Zalocki.
Zalocki checks in for the Wildcats. And Medina will check in for the Zebras. The second one by Garrick is good, as he'll sit down and Medina checks in. Also, I think the Matt Basham checking in for the Zebras. 1.7 as Cumberland cross midcourt, puts up the shot. Oh, in and out, no good. After one, the Rochester Zebras lead 17-5. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball on 92.1 WROI.
Hi, I'm Katie Seiler, 2013 graduate of Rochester High School. On Wednesday, January 15th at 6:30 in the cafeteria, Rochester High School will be hosting a financial aid night for students and their parents to learn more about financial aid. The guidance department here at Rochester High School is here to help you with your scholarship needs and to make your college dreams come true. Be sure to attend financial aid night on January 15th and apply for all of those scholarships that are offered.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Back to Rochester High School. The first quarter's in the books. We just had a score check, and it's 18-5 Rochester after one. And Rochester will have the ball as Camp will look to get it in for the Zebras. Does so to Screeton. Screeton working against Cumberland. Drives to the middle of the floor. Gives off to Medina. Medina into the corner to Camp. Camp looking down low to Abbott. Abbott across the paint to Medina. who gives down low to Basham, out to Camp. Camp's three-pointer is good. 21-5, Rochester, as we start this second quarter.
Zebras have found their shooting stroke over Christmas break. Nice job. Yeah. I'll tell you what, four or five guys touched the ball that possession. You know, they're getting some threes, but they're getting threes with good ball movement and
it's
being
within,
unselfish.
Within the offense that they're getting it. As Witko working against the tenacious Rochester man-to-man defense, Cumberland out by the midcourt gives to Adkins. Adkins against Medina gives to Walpole. Walpole set the offense and give back to Cumberland as Abbott plays defense against him to Adkins. Adkins drives baseline, gets triple teamed, finds Walpole, and then Cumberland as he drives into the paint, and he's going to be fouled.
Cumberland, thus far, the lone offensive threat for Witko. He's got all five of their points.
Camp going to pick up a foul for Rochester, his first.
I think Street called that on Street.
I'm sorry.
But that's the only downfall of the Zebras at this point. And they are being aggressive, but, you know, Witko's going to shoot free throws the rest of the half. Zebras getting in some foul trouble, 16 fouls.
So Cumberland, first free throw is good.
Yes, it's Rochester 21, Cumberland 6.
Wow.
Continues to be the only scoring threat for Witko.
Coach Reinholdt said he was their scoring threat before the game, and he's living up to that billing. He misses the second one, but the rebound by Adkinson as he puts it up, no good. The ball tipped around and finally out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Witko.
Green almost got a rebound laying on his back that time. The ball almost dropped right to him.
You're right.
Just out of his reach. That would have been a great way to get a rebound. Witko going to turn up the pressure. They got to do something. You're down 21-6. Try to turn the momentum of this game, maybe get some cheap buckets and get back into this thing.
So Screeton cross midcourt to Kennedy, over to Camp. Camp quickly down to Abbott on the baseline. Abbott around the defense, off the front of the rim, no good. And the ball is going to be tipped out, last touch by Medina. So Witko will get the ball back, trailing 21-6 with 6:37 left here in the second quarter. And Cumberland has
Zebras
been
going to turn around and extend the pressure here, go back to their 2-2-1 trap.
Abbott will put pressure on Cumberland. He tries to find Patrick in the corner and overthrows him.
Cumberland was trying to be a little cute. He was looking for the guy in his corner, his sideline, and thought he could throw that no-look diagonal pass off the dribble. That's
hard to do when you're looking. So Screeton will bring the ball up for the Zebras against Walpole. Gives to Camp. Camp stops just short of the midcourt. Back to Screeton, over to Abbott. Screeton now the free throw line down low to Medina. His shot partially blocked. And then the ball is lost out of bounds as it goes off Kennedy's fingers. Medina had a good look. I think he maybe just hesitated a little long before he put that off the glass.
Sometimes you don't expect yourself to be that wide open or the shot to be that easy. Yeah. Nobody was around him. Good, nice find by Carter to drive and draw the defense.
So Cumberland, has it knocked back into his face by Abbott. Recovers the ball, drives it quickly up across midcourt. Cumberland going to take it all the way. His little five-foot shot in the paint is no good. And the rebound to Medina. Medina to Screeton. Screeton quickly up to Abbott, and he travels.
Yep. He had the right idea in mind. Is just
be quick, but don't hurry kind of thing.
That's right. He's looking in the right place. He's got to slow down. Coach Reinholdt going to take a timeout. Looks like it's going to be a 30.
Timeout here by Rochester. You're listening to 92.1 WROI. And we're all about
pets. It's all in the name, and it's all about pets. It really is all about pets. All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet. And we're all about
pets. Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. Rochester leading the Witko Wildcats by score 21-6 with 5:53 to go here in the second quarter. Witko with the ball as Walpole gives to Kern as he brings it up across midcourt. And it's stolen by Kennedy. Kennedy on the fast break the other way kind of passes the ball to himself and gets it off the glass. I'm not sure that should have been traveled, but he kind of lost it and caught it in midair and got the layup. Witko.
Rochester changing their pressure look, going to a 1-2-2.
Throws it away. This time Camp with the steal, and he's fouled going in for the layup.
I think that's going to be on Kern. That's his first. Whitco's fifth. Nice coaching lead by Coach Reinholdt. They'd run the 2-2-1, and you know, Whitco called the timeout, probably going to adjust to that. And Coach counters with the 1-2-2, give him a different look, and the Zebras have forced two straight turnovers with it.
The Camp's first free throw is good. 24-6 in favor of Rochester.
Here, I think Camp already, I think this is his fourth point. That might be his career high already.
Wow.
Usually gets maybe a bucket and when he gets into games if he scores, but at least for this year, at least I think it's a season high.
Garrick checks back in as Abbott sits down. Camp's second one, no good. Garrick with the rebound. His shot off the glass is good.
Zebra basket number 24.
26-6, Rochester here, 5:17 to go in the second quarter. Whitco with the basketball, Cumberland working to get it up across midcourt. Walpole finally does, gives to Adkins. Adkins drives in against Kennedy, and we're going to have a travel.
Yeah, sometimes it's getting, you know, press works by getting turnovers off of steals or dribbles, and sometimes it just works because you get the other team out of control and
frustrated and thinking faster than they can react.
Yep. Yeah.
So Holland checks back in for Rochester. Screeton brings the ball up, gives to Medina on the baseline. Medina brings it back out front to Garrick, to Holland. He looks at a three, gives down low to Medina, out to Kennedy. Kennedy fakes the three and travels in the process.
He had that good offensive start. Obviously, they're going to come out and start contesting those threes after he hit those three. And
yeah,
that's, again, once again, the right idea. He just shuffled his feet before he started dribbling.
He's got 13 points now in the game already.
Yeah.
Kennedy.
Yep.
So Whitco passing down low into the corner. Patrick finds himself double-teamed and gives the little shove to find some room. And Holland's going to draw the offensive foul.
Well, they're going to give the coach a timeout before any of that happens.
Oh. So no foul. They're going to give Whitco the timeout. You're listening to Rochester Basketball on 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Whitco's basketball out of bounds. They trail by 20 here midway through the second quarter. Cumberland looking to get it in and does so in the front court to Walpole. Walpole quickly across midcourt. Guarded by Screeton. Walpole looking for an opening. Finds Adkins back to Cumberland. Cumberland with all six Whitco points. Gives back to Walpole, top of the key to Adkins. Adkins now will drive around to Cumberland. Cumberland sets the offense. He gets the ball back from Walpole and gives back to Walpole, top of the key. Three is good. 26-9 with 4 minutes to go here in the second. Medina with the basketball as the Zebras get it up court quickly to Kennedy. Kennedy tries to go cross court, has the ball stolen. The Walpole gives to Cumberland. His ball tipped away by Holland. And the behind-the-back pass from Cumberland to Zawalki. And we're going to have a foul coming on Garrick.
Garrick's second, Rochester seventh. So as I said earlier, Whitco's going to be shooting free throws the remainder of the half.
So 6'2", Zawalki, senior for Whitco, at the free throw line to shoot two. First one is good. 3:56 to go here in the second quarter. Abbott checks back in, and Garrick will sit down. Zawalki's second free throw bounces around and falls through. 26-11. The Zebras with the basketball and the lead as Screeton comes across midcourt, loses the handle. Cumberland picks up the loose ball, driving the other way, and his shot is no good, and Screeton going to pick up the foul.
McCarter's second, team eight.
He just simply lost the handle on the dribble coming across midcourt. He was looking at a trap and was, I think, looking to see where to go with the basketball and just kind of lost his dribble.
Yeah, the Zebras had kind of cleared out. Everybody had gotten out of the way, and as soon as Carter crossed half court, Witko sent a second defender, and he was thinking about getting rid of the ball but couldn't find the handle on it to get rid of the pass.
Cumberland's first free throw is good. They'll have one more.
It's one thing you don't want to do when you have a big lead is foul the other team and let them score with the clock stopped. I know we're only in the first half, but you're going to get yourself in some foul situation into the second half if this continues as well.
You're right. So the second free throw by Cumberland is good. 26-13 now in favor of Rochester as Holland will work it up against this trap, mid-court, half-court trap, almost. And Witko does get the steal. Waffle comes up with a loose ball, tries to get it to Atkins, and has it stolen by Basham. He gives a Screeton, and Screeton's going to be called for the charge.
That's going to be Carter's third foul of the half.
And he just kind of dropped that shoulder, just a little bit of a dip as he went forward. That's all it took. You know, it's not even one of those, there's intent there. If you dip that shoulder as you make contact, and he knew the contact was coming.
Defender did a good job selling it, too.
Yeah.
But, yeah, legal guarding position. You don't have to get completely set still. You just have a right to that space where you're there. And, you know, even if you're, you're upright, you don't have to be stationary completely either.
So Witko, when they brought the ball down again, threw it out of bounds against that Zebra trap. So Rochester will get the basketball back. Holland gets it into camp, back to Holland. Holland will walk it up the court against Walpole. Stops just short of midcourt. Camp will bring it across. Drives to the free throw line down low to Basham as he hesitates before putting it up and travels in the process. Right idea. It's a shot fake, but he just shuffled his feet in doing so.
Well, maybe a situation where, I don't know, this some weather-related, you know, the difference week. You're just kind of out of sync a little bit, although Zebra's scoring well.
Yeah,
but
schedule's been messed up all week, and those are chemistry right now.
Wow.
The steal by the Zebras turned back over to Witko, and Witko's shot by Walpole rolls off the back of the rim and in. The Zebras bring it quickly up across midcourt, leading 26-15 with 2:40 to go here in the second quarter. Holland, the top of the key to Camp. Camp from the right side three is no good. He comes crashing in for the rebound. Walpole comes down with it for Witko, and he brings it quickly up to the other side of the floor, kicks it out to Patrick for a three. It's good. 26-18 in favor of Rochester. Coach Reinhold's going to take a 30. You're listening to 92.1 WROI.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. Rochester Zebras with a 26-18 lead after a couple of quick baskets by Witko. You got some delays there, Tony?
Yeah, Valley Northfield boys postponed tonight until Tuesday. Southwood Wabash boys also postponed tonight, so not many games going around the area. Some good girls action. West Central defeated Caston 36-33 in overtime. And Triton is leading. Triton and John Glenn are tied at half. That's a great girls' game. John Glenn girls are undefeated, and we know how good Triton girls are.
Well, Holland's three-pointer was off the mark, but Kennedy right there with the rebound to put it back for the Zebras as they lead by 10 now. It's been as much as 20.
Kennedy now is 15.
So Witko with the basketball has a pass stolen. Abbott picks up the steal, takes it to the other end of the floor for the Zebras and lays it in. 30-18 with 1:50 to go here in the second quarter. And Cumberland will walk it up for the Wildcats against the half-court trap by the Rochester Zebras. Cumberland cross court to Patrick. Patrick tries to go back to Cumberland, has the pass stolen by Abbott. Abbott again down the other side of the floor for the Zebras. Finds himself in the paint and in trouble, and he's going to be fouled by Witko. And Patrick's going to pick up that foul.
That's Patrick's first, team six. I'll tell you what, Brett Abbott's just back to his football days. He's just playing free safety out there.
Yeah,
his defensive back skills are coming in handy. He's just reading passers, reading eyes, and stepping in the passing lane.
Abbott gets it into Holland. Holland to Kennedy. Kennedy turns and looks, drives baseline. Pulls up his dribble, gives to Basham at the free throw line. Back to Abbott. Abbott will set the offense at the top of the key. Drives down into the paint. Gets a shot off the glass. It's good.
Four quick points for Abbott.
1:10 left here in the second quarter. Rochester by 14. As Cumberland brings it across for Whitco to Patrick. Down low to Adkins. His shot off the glass is good.
Number 11, Devin Adkins.
So Holland quickly for the Zebras across midcourt to Abbott. Abbott looks down low to Basham. Basham off the glass, no good. Rebound by Whitco. Patrick gives to Walpool. Will bring the ball up for the Wildcats. Cross midcourt, 40 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Zebras ahead. Cumberland gives to Adkins. His shot off the glass is good. And the Zebras looking to get it in. Do so to Camp. Back to Holland with 27 seconds to go here in the half. Zebras by 10. Holland to Camp. They'll pull it out. Wait for the last shot. 20 seconds. Abbott working against Walpool. To Holland. Holland will hold with 10 seconds. 9, 8, Holland, top of the key, drives down the left baseline, shot off the glass, no good. Rebound to Walpool, he pushes the other way, one shot, no good. So at halftime, Rochester leads 32-22 over the Whitco Wildcats. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Hi, I'm Katie Seiler, 2013 graduate of Rochester High School. On Wednesday, January 15th at 6:30 in the cafeteria, Rochester High School will be hosting a financial aid night for students and their parents to learn more about financial aid. The guidance department here at Rochester High School is here to help you with your scholarship needs and to make your college dreams come true. Be sure to attend financial aid night on January 15th and apply for all of those scholarships that are offered.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
And go back inside and get some work in the paint.
So Whitco starts the second half with the basketball. Walpool gives to Cumberland. I guess that trap by the Zebras as they knock the ball back across midcourt. Walpool picks up the loose ball, gives to Cumberland. Cumberland to the free throw line to Adkins. Back out to Walpool, and he travels.
Yep.
The Rochester Zebras defense doing a great job tonight. Just maybe one or two breakdowns there in the second quarter that got Coach Reinholt a little upset, but
and there, a nice adjustment by Coach putting Taylor Medina at the top of the 1-2-2, get some length, and then an athlete up there harder for Whitco to pass around him.
So Screeton will bring the ball up for the Zebras to start the second half, and Gehrig now on the right side working against Cumberland off to Holland. His three-pointer is in good. Alec Holland with a three-pointer to get the Zebras started here in the second half.
Alec now has seven.
Walpool will bring the ball up, working against Medina, over to Cumberland. Cumberland cross midcourt, gives it up to Helbig. Back to Walpool. His shot no good. He steals the ball from Gehrig and lays it up off the glass. Gehrig got the loose ball rebound on the missed shot, but an errant pass went to Wahlberg, and he's able to lay it up.
trying to aggressively look ahead. He had a guard right next to him, and he was trying to pass ahead, and Walpole made a nice read and picked it off.
Yeah. Witko a lot more aggressive here in the second half defensively. They managed to cut a 20-point lead to 10 and now trail by 11. As Screeton gets down low to Kennedy, his shot off the glass is good. He shoots over Helbig.
Like that head and shoulder fake. You know, the guy didn't jump, but it still got him in rhythm. He did not bring the ball back down either. You like to see that.
So Cumberland brings the ball across midcourt for the Wildcats, gives the Adkins at the block down to Walpole. Walpole's going to be called for travel.
You know, sometimes we talked about different things the press can do, the steals or get him out of control, or sometimes it's the thought of where the press is coming from that gets them confused.
Right,
they expect it to come a certain way, and it doesn't, and that confuses them just as much as when the pressure does get there.
6'2 senior Danny Zalot checks in for the Wildcats, and Helbig sits down. Screeton will bring the ball up for the Zebras, gives to Garrig. Garrig working into the free throw line. His shot off the glass is in and out, no good. Rebound by Witko, and Cumberland will walk the ball up. Gives to Walpole. Walpole to Cumberland. Cumberland across midcourt to Zawaki as he tries to go down low to Adkins and has it tipped out of bounds. 5:58 to go here in the third quarter. Rochester leading 37-24. Witko's basketball under their own basket. I'm Brad Thomas. Tony Stasiak alongside tonight. David Musselman recovering from knee surgery. Wahlberg with the ball for Witko. Gives to Zawaki, and he loses the handle out of bounds. Goes back to Rochester. Kennedy will get it into Holland. Holland will bring it across midcourt. Picks up his dribble, gives to Kennedy. Kennedy gives to Screeton. Screeton now. Across midcourt to Garrig. Garrig to Kennedy on the baseline, and we're going to have an illegal screen on Carter Screeton.
That's a big foul. That's Carter
four. Yep. And so Screeton will come to the bench with his fourth foul, and Camp will check in for the Zebras. Witko will bring the ball up the floor. Medina and Camp will pick them up at midcourt. Cumberland and Wahlberg. Cumberland across midcourt, and he's going to be hip checked by Garrig.
That's a great hockey move, not so much in basketball.
Right. So Garrig will pick up his third, the 5:25 mark of the third quarter. Rochester leading 37-24. Patrick looks at a three, pulls it back down, drives across the free throw line, gives to Cumberland. Cumberland back out to Walpole. Walpole then to Adkins. Adkins working against Medina, gives to Patrick. To Walpole, his shot is blocked by Camp. And Camp with the loose ball gives to Kennedy. Kennedy is going to be called for travel. So Luke Kennedy trying to work against Zalocki and bring the ball up for the Zebras. Called for the travel and turns it back over to Witko. They try to check the ball and the referee gives the ball just as they walk away from it. So Patrick now will bring it in for Witko to Walpole. Walpole working against Camp gives to Cumberland. A long three-pointer, no good. And Garrig on the long rebound quickly up the floor gives off to Camp, and Camp is quickly fouled by Cumberland.
Cumberland second, team's first.
So good heads-up play by Garrig on the long miss by Cumberland on Cumberland's three. Quickly gets the ball up floor. The Zebras will have it out of bounds under their basket as Medina gets the inbounds pass from Kennedy and puts it in off the glass. 39-24 in favor of Rochester. Witko will work the ball up across midcourt against that half-court trap and going to throw it away as Garrig did a great job of saving that ball back in. And Medina comes up with the loose ball, gives the Camp down, and then to Kennedy down low on the baseline. And he's going to be fouled in the process of shooting. Finds a Lockie.
His first, team second. One thing Luke hasn't done yet is gone to the free throw line. I'll take care of that here shortly with two shots. Trying to add to his 17 points he's got thus far.
So the 6'4 senior, Luke Kennedy, step to the line. 4-2. Zebras leading by 15. His first one is up and good. He'll have one more. Patrick. I'm sorry, Abbott will look to check in for the Zebras. And Gehrig will sit down with three fouls. Is that right? Or has he got two?
Yeah, Gehrig's got three.
Got three?
Yep.
So Kennedy's second free throw is good. Rochester leading 41-24, 4:28 to go here in the third. Witko loses the handle. Cumberland loses the handle. Camp picks up the loose ball and lays it in. And then we're going to have a timeout by Witko, a full timeout by Witko. You're listening to Rochester Basketball 92.1 WROI.
Local people making a big difference when it comes to insurance needs. Insurance does not have to be complicated. That's why Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance are your local trusted choice agent. They have access to multiple insurance carriers that offer competitive pricing and individual coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
It's just nonsense the way some water softener companies claim electricity is the only thing that matters when it comes to better water. Culligan embraces technology. Their water softeners use $3 a year in electricity. That $3 a year powers their smart sensor, the brain of the softener, so it recharges only when needed. That means you don't waste salt or water the way brainless non-electric softeners do. Start saving today by calling Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2420, and trying the smarter solution to hard water for only $10 a month. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. Witko will have the basketball. They trail by 19 with 4:20 to go here in the third quarter. And Cumberland will look to get it in against a full court man-to-man. Is that what that is? Full court man-to-man press by the Zebras. Now they're going to back off and pick them up mid-court. Yep. Camp picks up Cumberland right at the timeline, and he'll work to the right side, give to Patrick. Patrick to Walpole. Walpole working against Holland, brings it back across the top of the key to Cumberland, then to Patrick, and has his ball stolen by Kennedy. Kennedy the other way as Cumberland comes in and tries to slap it away. Kennedy will be going back to the free throw line to shoot two.
Cumberland's third, team's third.
And Cumberland can ill afford to get into foul trouble for Witko. Their offense runs through him.
Yeah, Zebra's done a much better job. He has yet to score in this half after an 8-point first half. Luke's on the doorstep of 20. He's got 19 right now.
Wow. And the Zebras lead by 19. Kennedy hits his first free throw.
Checking in with Witko, number 33, Ian Kerr.
Kennedy with 20 now. The Zebras lead by 20. It's probably not a coincidence.
True.
Kennedy's second one is good as well. 3:56 to go here in the third quarter. Witko with the basketball as Kern gives to Walpole, back to Patrick. Patrick will bring it across midcourt for the Wildcats. He works against Abbott in a man-to-man defense. He loses the handle, and Camp picks up the loose ball, takes it down the other end for the Zebras. Layup, and it's good, and a foul.
Nice move by Camp. That foul's going to be on Walpole. Walpole, his first, only team's fourth. Brandy Camp, I know this has got to be career high. It's 8 points.
So Camp will go to the line to finish the three-point play. And he does.
Nice job by the young man.
48-24 in favor of Rochester. 3:38 to go here in the third. Walpole for the Wildcats will bring it up. Carpenter's on the bench with three fouls for the Wildcats. And Camp, Abbott now going to pick up the fouls. Patrick brought his ball across midcourt.
But second, team third.
Matt Basham will check in for the Zebras, and Kennedy will get a breather.
Number five, Dylan Cumberland.
Well-deserved Kennedy, break there.
good ball game for Luke Kennedy. And Helblig will check back in for the Wildcats as Zawalki will sit down. Walpole with the ball now for the Wildcats, working against Camp across midcourt into a double team as Holland comes up to set the trap. Walpole dribbles around, and he's going to be called for a five-second violation.
Good job by the Zebras not bailing him out and trying to reach and grab it. Let the man just dribble out. Five-second violation. Zebra ball.
Camp did a good job of staying with his man. Holland did a good job of coming up trying to set the trap. The Zebras now with the basketball. as Holland will bring her across midcourt with 3:13 to go here in the third quarter. Gives to Camp on the far side. Camp to Medina at the top of the key. Back to Abbott here on the right side. Abbott down low to Camp. Nothing on the baseline, so Camp brings it out front. Holland to the free throw line. Down low to Basham. His shot off the glass is good.
Amazing how ball reversals usually get you easy shots on the backside. Yep. Keep that ball moving, make the defense go side to side. You usually end up with a good look.
So Abbott is going to pick up the foul as Cumberland checks back in for Whitco. And they immediately get the basketball to him, and Abbott picks up the foul. His third, team's fourth. Now Cumberland will look to check it in for Whitco. Does so to Helblig, who gives the Walpool. Walpool's drive and shot off the glass is no good. And Basham and Helblig get tied up on the rebound. And the possession is going to go to Rochester. .236 to go here in the third quarter. Rochester leads 50-24.
The Zebras on an 18-2 run this quarter right now.
Their largest lead of the game. Abbott with the basketball gives to Holland. Holland brings it across midcourt for the Zebras all the way down the middle of the lane before he loses a handle on it. And he's going to be called for travel as he tries to pick the ball up.
Now it got into fifth gear there a little bit, and he's faster than anybody else, but he's got to stay in fourth gear to maintain his control there. Lost ball out of bounds.
So Whitco with the basketball. So Helblig gives to Carpenter. Carpenter to, who was that, 23?
Yep. Yes,
Milwaukee.
Yep.
His jumper was good. Medina with the basketball for the Zebras. To Basham. Basham on the baseline. Gives it out front to Holland's three-pointers. No good. And it'd be turned back over to Whitco. I think Holland was hoping for some contact there on that three-point shot as he kind of forced it up.
He didn't get contact in terms of drawing foul. That's what he was trying to do, but yeah. I thought maybe there was a deflection by a Whitco player.
A long pass by Whitco to Walpools leads to an easy layup at the other end. The Zebras quickly back the other way as Abbott gets the pass from Holland. Gives the Camp back to Holland at the top of the key, working against Walpool, loses the handle on the basketball, and is going to be called for a travel as Holland and Walpool fight for the loose ball. Holland gets called for the travel.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. He did not have possession when
he
got up.
He
can get up if you don't have possession of the ball. That's a loose ball, and he got up off the floor and started dribbling.
So Cumberland will bring the ball up for Whitco. Working against Camp, and Camp's going to get called for a little check.
Yeah, Mr. Camp playing a good game tonight. That's only his first foul, team fifth.
Carrick will check in for the Zebras, and Adkins will check in for the Wildcats. Bolowski sitting down, as Holland does as well. Cumberland will look to get it in for the Wildcats. Does so to Adkins, and he is fouled immediately, I think, by Medina.
So it's going to be Medina's second, team six. Just when he thought the referees might let him play a little bit,
right.
They decided they found their whistles and it's going to continue to use them.
So Devon Adkins, a sophomore, hits the first free throw. He'll have one more. The Zebras lead 50-29. 1:35 to go here in the third quarter. The JV won their game 47-18. And they were led by Tristan Foster's 16 and Dominic Thomas's 11 and Noah Dahlquist's 10.
Three JV guys in double figures.
Yeah.
That's good to see.
As
good
Adkins makes the second free throw. Quickly, the Zebras get the ball up court to the baseline to Abbott. Abbott trying to get out of trouble on the baseline.
Kick ball.
Well, we're going to have a kick. Yeah, we're going to have a kick ball, and the Zebras will have it out of the bounds right here in front of their own bench. So Abbott will bring the ball in for the Zebras right in front of Coach Reinhold. He looks, still looking, gets it into Garrett. Garrett out front, gives back to Abbott. Over to Camp. The Zebras going to look to be a little patient here, run some clock off. And just as I say that, Kemp turns it over. Lost the handle on the dribble, and then he didn't have any place to go with it. He tried to go down low and took too big a step. Witko with the basketball now. Cumberland will bring it in with a minute to go here in the third quarter. Gives to Kern. Kern to Helblig. To Cumberland down low, back to Helblig, and he's going to lose it on the baseline. And Medina now for the Zebras will check the ball in with 56 seconds to go as Holland checks back in. Camp sits down.
Alex coming in. Maybe try to milk this last minute, get the last shot, finish the quarter.
53 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Holland with the basketball for Rochester, and again called for the travel coming across midcourt as he picked the ball up and shuffled his feet trying to make the pass.
Kind of a common theme for the Zebras. Just when you think, you know, a good start in the first quarter, and then they kind of took a couple steps back in the second.
Starting to creep in.
Come out strong to start the third, and now they're getting a little loose with the basketball here. And
so Camp will check back in for defensive purposes for the Zebras as Witko brings the ball up cross midcourt. That's Kern with the basketball, gives to Cumberland. Cumberland working against the trap by the Zebras and steps out of bounds. 41 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Cumberland stepped out of bounds as the Zebras applied the trap on the baseline.
Number three, Alex.
And now Holland will check in, and Kennedy will check in. Basham and Camp will sit down.
I don't know if they do, but if these coaches like to run sprints for turnovers, these boys are going to be awfully busy next practice.
So Holland coming across midcourt gives to Garrig. Garrig across the timeline. Gives to Abbott. 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Holland will hold as the clock ticks down to 25. Gives to Medina in the corner. And Medina's pass back to Abbott is tipped out of bounds with 21 seconds to go. The Zebras leading by 20 here at the end of the third quarter. Abbott will look to get it in. Still looking. Does so to Garrig. Garrig in the front court. We'll bring it across the timeline to the free throw line. Out to Medina. To Holland with 12. To Abbott. Back to Holland. Top of the key with 8. With 6 goes to Kennedy. Kennedy with 3 gives to Garrig. Garrig throws up a shot at the buzzer. No good. So at the end of 3, Rochester leads 50-30 over Witko. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Hi, I'm Katie Seiler, 2013 graduate of Rochester High School. On Wednesday, January 15th at 6:30 in the cafeteria, Rochester High School will be hosting a financial aid night for students and their parents to learn more about financial aid. The guidance department here at Rochester High School is here to help you with your scholarship needs and to make your college dreams come true. Be sure to attend financial aid night on January 15th and apply for all of those scholarships that are offered.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Back to Rochester High School to get ready to start the fourth and final quarter. Rochester leading by 20, 50-30 over the Witko Wildcats. They look to push their TRC record to 2-0 tonight. Witko with the basketball. They get it in to Helblig, who gives to Cumberland. Cumberland looking at the man-to-man defense by Rochester. Gives to Adkins on the right wing. Adkins down low to Cumberland. His pass is knocked out of bounds by Garrig. And Witko will maintain possession.
Zebras, of course, a lot of turnovers, but they've also got several deflections. They're doing a nice job of anticipating passes and getting a hand on it, just like that on the inbounds play.
So the inbounds pass by Cumberland is tipped away, I think, by Kennedy. And Helblick's not able to get a handle on it. They're going to say last touch by Rochester. I think both teams thought the other team touched it. They were both just waiting for the ball to roll out of bounds.
Yeah.
So Witko's going to get it. Walpole to Cumberland. Cumberland here on the sideline, works back towards the middle of the floor, gives to Adkins at the free throw line. To Cumberland, his shot from just inside the arc is no good, but the rebound by Witko, and Kurd's shot is blocked by Medina.
Yeah.
And Rochester coming back the other way, and they're going to call Garrig on a charge as he tries to work against Cumberland down low.
Alex fourth. Team 7th. Just on that block by Medina, possession before. I don't even think the ball got out of the young man's hands. Medina almost took it from him before he shot it.
Medina got the start tonight, and I think he's done a pretty good job for the Zebras.
Yeah, for what they need him to do, get some rebounds, play good defense, be an athlete.
Witko with the basketball, trailing by 20 here in the fourth quarter. With 7:10 to go, Cumberland gives to Walpool in the corner, almost loses his footing. Gives to Kern, back to Cumberland. They look to try and get the ball reversed against the defense. Walpool down low to Helbig, and his shot rolls over the front of the rim and is good. And Rochester now will come across midcourt as Holland brings the ball up, gives to Garrig on the right side. Garrig back towards midcourt, working against Cumberland, and they're going to call Cumberland on a hand check.
That's his fourth.
That's going to be spell trouble for Witko if he picks up that fifth foul.
That coach is going to let him ride out. No choice for Witko.
Right.
If you lose him, you're not going to have much of a chance anyway. So
Brandon Camp will check back in for Rochester as Matt Basham will sit down. Abbott gets the ball in to Kennedy. Kennedy to Medina. Medina will bring the ball out and give to Holland. Holland works the top of the key to Camp. Camp has a ball stolen by Walpool, who Camp then comes from behind and tips it out of bounds.
I think they're going to call Camp for a foul,
unfortunately. Oh, they did. They did, actually, Jim. But Camp lost the ball to Walpool in an attempt to knock it out of bounds and save the layup. It's called for the foul. So Walpool will go to the line for 1-1 for the Wildcats. And his first one is no good. Rebound by Kennedy. And he gives to Abbott. Abbott working against man-to-man defense by Witko. And he's going to be called for the double dribble as he tries to split the double team defense by the Wildcats and turns it over. 50-32 with 6:22 to go here in the fourth quarter. Rochester leads. And Witko's going to call timeout. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball on 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come. Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now that we're into 2014, basketball, swimming, and wrestling are going strong. The pro football playoffs continue, and the Winter Olympics will be here soon. So there's plenty to do. Whether it's heading for the gym, outdoor activities, or getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. Witko with the basketball. Walpool working against Holland, top of the key. Cumberland down the baseline. Gives to Walpool in the corner. His jumper, no good. Medina with the rebound for Rochester. 6 minutes to go here in the basketball game. Rochester leading by 18. Kennedy at midcourt gives to Medina. Medina down to Camp working in the corner. To Medina, back out to Screeton. Screeton, the top of the key with Walpool right in his grill. Medina works the right side. Nothing on the baseline. Gives down low to Kennedy. Has that pass stolen by Cumberland. Cumberland coming back the other way for Witko. His shot off the glass is no good, and they're going to call Cumberland with a foul on the charge. That's his fifth. And that spells trouble for Witco.
Yeah, as they lose their best ball handler and leading scorer.
Although he has been quiet. He has not scored this half. He had 8 points in the first half. He's going to finish with eight. Has not scored.
So the senior Dylan Cumberland fouls out for Witco. And I didn't see who they checked in.
I think it was 33.
Okay.
15 now.
So Kern.
Yeah.
Checks in for Wolf Cumberland. Zebras bring the ball up quickly. Camp tries to go baseline to Medina and has it knocked out of bounds, or loses it out of bounds. I'm sorry. Witco's basketball now. Witco trails by 18.
Coach, remind them, you're up 18, guys. 5 minutes to go. Make the easy play. You don't have to
right.
Make the SportsCenter highlight reel play.
So Walpole working against Holland, almost loses it. Gets it back from Adkins. His jumper at the top of the key rolls in. That'll be a two-pointer. 5:10 to go. Rochester with the 16-point lead. Medina in the corner. Gives back to Holland. Holland works across the top of the key, down low. Across the free throw, and he tries to go down low to Kennedy, and before he could attempt the jump shot or jump stop and the pass, he gets called for a travel.
Kind of a repeat, you know, with good first quarter by the Zebras, struggled in the second quarter. Good third quarter by the Zebras, now struggling in the fourth, have not yet scored, and we're 3 minutes into the fourth quarter.
Yeah. Walpole works the ball against Holland, gives to Kern. Kern over to Welpley. That's who came in for Cumberland.
Mm-hmm.
Kern drives into the paint. His shot off the glass, no good. Helbig with the rebound. His shot off the glass, no good. And the rebound fought for and come up by Medina for Rochester. He gives off the Screeton. 4:28 to go here in the fourth quarter. Rochester leading by 16 as Screeton will bring it up and pull it back out and set the offense. He works the right side, gives to Holland. Holland in the corner, gives to Screeton, back out front to Kennedy, and Kennedy travels.
Haven't been keeping track of turnovers, but I think it's safe to say Zebras have more turnovers than shots definitely in this quarter.
Yeah. And Witco's going to take another timeout with 4:13 to go here in the fourth quarter. Rochester leading by 16. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods. Created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School. Here in the fourth quarter, 4:13 to go. Rochester leading Witco by a score of 50-34. And Witco's basketball. As they have lost their leading scorer in Dylan Cumberland, and ball handler for that matter. And so they'll look to get it in as Kern does so to Walpole. The freshman, 6 foot freshman Nate Walpole for Witco, works against Holland as he brings it across midcourt, gives to Wepley. Wepley back to Walpole to Kern. Kern to top of the key, gives to Adkins, tries to go down low and has the ball stolen by Kennedy. Then Kennedy cross court to Holland, almost has it stolen by Kern, and he commits the foul.
Good heads up play by Alec Holland. What made that play is he stepped towards his pass to meet it rather than wait for the ball to get there. And because he did that, the defender had to go through him to try to make the turnover. And Alec's going to shoot some free throws.
So Alec Holland at the free throw line, the sophomore for the Zebras.
He's got 7 to this point.
His first one is up and no good. I'm sorry, it was 1-1. The rebound by Kennedy, and he throws one up off the rim and is fouled. So now Luke Kennedy will go to the free throw line to add to his impressive totals for the evening.
Yeah, he's got 21. Like the rest of the Zebras, scoreless this quarter halfway through.
So Kyle Wepley picked up the foul for Witco. Kennedy's first free throw is good.
22 for the big man.
It's a good night.
I'd say unofficially, seems like he's got about 7-8 boards.
I would agree with that. His second free throw is good. 23 now for the senior. And Witco will bring the ball up quickly. Walpole cross timeline, works against Holland. He'll drive and shoot from 10 feet. No good. Kennedy with another board. Gives off to Screeton with 3:30 to go in the ball game. And Screeton working against Walpole gets it across midcourt. The Zebras with the 18-point lead, and Screeton is going to turn it over. Lost the handle and went back across midcourt.
So
Kennedy is going to take a seat.
Done as night might be done, but great effort by the senior.
23 points. Noah Dahlquist, who had 10 points for the JV in the JV win tonight, checks in for the Zebras. And Witko inbounds pass, loses it. Medina comes up with the loose ball. And the Zebras with 3:20 will get the basketball back, leading by 18. Holland to Screeton on the right wing. To Medina at the top of the key to Camp. Camp will hold. Looks down low. No one open. Tries to get it over to Holland. Does so. Holland here on the right side will now drive to the free throw line. And in doing so, he's fouled.
Going to
be
by Helbig.
Helbig, third team's eighth. So still 1-1 for Alex.
So Medina will sit down and Matt Basham will check in. Medina likely done for the night.
Shooting 1-1 for the Zebras.
Combination of Kennedy and Medina playing together, I think, is a good look for the Zebras.
That's a good combination down low. Gives them good size. Holland's first free throw is good. 53-34, Rochester again stretching this back out to a sizable lead. Holland's second shot is good. And Dom Thomas will check in for the Zebras, and Camp will sit down.
Great job by Brandon Camp. Just missed double digits with 9 points. Missed a free throw. He could have got there, but great effort by the young man. Coach called him an energy guy. Certainly gave the Zebras a boost off the bench scoring-wise tonight.
He did. Witko with the basketball, 2:50 to go here in the ballgame. They trail by 20 as Witko to Walpole to Welpley. Welpley's long three-pointer is good off the glass. 54-37 in favor of Rochester. 2:37 to go in the game. Holland quickly across midcourt, and he will look to bring it back out front to Dom Thomas. Thomas with the basketball, driving across midcourt, gives to Screeton. Screeton looking down low to Thomas. Thomas to Dahlquist. Down low to Basham. Basham across court to Screeton. Screeton's three is in and out, no good. And we're going to have a pushing foul against Witko.
I think so. Foul's going to be on number 23 for Witko.
So Lockie,
his second.
And Matt Basham going to go to the line.
Number 32, Matt Basham.
For the Zebras. His first free throw is good.
He had a field goal in the third quarter, so he got 3 points.
Devin Atkins
and Helbling will check back in for Witko.
Seven different Zebras have scored tonight. That's some solid balance there.
Yeah, it is. The second free throw is no good. Atkins with the rebound for Witko. 2 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Rochester leading 55-37. Walpole with the basketball. Top of the key for Witko. Working against Holland. Drives in, gives to Wepley. Wepley out to Kern. Back around to Walpole. Walpole to Atkins at the top of the key. Atkins to the elbow. Loses it. Holland picks his pocket and brings it back across the other way for the Zebras. Holland's pass to Screeton in the corner. He looks down low, gives it to Thomas. Thomas looking for Dahlquist. Can't find him. Then he does on the baseline. Dahlquist working the baseline against Atkins. Gives to Basham. Basham's shot off the glass is good.
Basham's got five.
Walpole back across midcourt with a minute 20 to go in the basketball game. Witko will call a 60-second timeout. with the Zebras leading by 20. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
WROI Rochester. Zebra Basketball. WROI.
Welcome back to Rochester High School. 1:19 to go in the fourth quarter. Rochester leading 57-37 over the Whitco Wildcats. Rochester looking to run their record to 3-5 and 2-0 in the TRC. Whitco Walpool with the basketball out front, working against Abbott. Drives to the baseline, throws a shot up after the contact. No good. Dahlquist with the rebound for Rochester. Holland quickly across midcourt, and then he'll pull it out with a minute to go in the basketball game. Rochester leading by 20. Holland out front. Down low to Thomas. Thomas' little hook shot in the lane is no good. Fights gets his own rebound. Gives down low to Basham. Basham a shot up off the glass is good. So Matt Basham gets a hard hot bucket there off the glass to go, and Whitco will walk it up with 40 seconds to go, trailing by 22. Walpool out front, working against the man-to-man defense. Stolen by Dahlquist by Rochester as he brings it back down the other side. His shot off the glass is no good, but he's fouled.
Foul's going to be on Edkins, his second, team's 10th.
And Noah Dahlquist, the 6'4 junior, will go to the free throw line to shoot two for Rochester.
Might be his attempt at his first varsity points. I don't think he's scored yet this year. Maybe only made a couple appearances.
And the first one is no good. He had 10 points in the JV win earlier tonight.
Nice anticipation for the big man on that pass to read that and make a play in the passing lane.
Yep, stepped in front of the pass.
There he goes. Think he might need his first varsity points.
Gets the second one to go. Rochester leading 60-37 with 20 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter as Walpool dribbles around the top of the key, gives to Adkins with 16 seconds. Adkins back to Wepley, to Kern, to Walpool on the opposite side. His shot is up with and partially blocked, but they're going to call the foul on Abbott with 10 seconds to go in the basketball game.
Last thing you want when you're up 22 with 10 seconds to go is try to contest a jump shot.
Yeah. So the freshman, Nate Walpool, will go to the line for Whitco. His first one is no good. We'll have one more.
Young man has 11 points tonight. Ends up being a leading scorer for Whitco.
For a freshman, I thought he played pretty well.
Yeah.
His second one is good. 60-38, favor of Rochester. The last 10 seconds click off the clock as Holland brings it across midcourt. 4 seconds to go, and he's just going to stand and hold. One, and that'll do it. Rochester Zebras will run their mark to 3-5, 2-0 in the TRC. Whitco will drop to 1-9, 0-2 in the TRC. When we come back, Tony will have our final stats for us, and we'll get a quick chat in with Coach Rex Reinhold. Again, Rochester beats Whitco by a score of 60-38. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball.